Hello, my name is Grace. Today I'm going to read the story. The Case of the Puzzling Possum. There is chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. Chapter 1, Buttons. Bunny collected buttons. She had a lot of them, probably a million. Bunny, you have got problem. You got probably a million buttons, said Jack. Every time he visited. Yes, said Bunny proudly. They're all buttons. Jack looked at the buttons. Buttons are brown. Bunny, he said. They're not, said Bunny. They don't do anything, said Jack. Why don't you collect fun stuff like trains? I like buttons better, said Bunny. But why? Asked Jack. Because they're nice and quiet, unlike some raccoons I know, said Bunny. I am nice, said Jack. You will be even nicer if you make me a cup of cocoa, said Bunny. I can do that, said Jack. And I can be quiet too. Okay, said Bunny. Ring, went the telephone. If it's for me, I am not here, said Jack. I am beginning nice and quietly today. Ha, said Bunny. She picked up the phone. Hello, she said. Jack tried to listen while he fixed the cocoa. Really? Bunny said. Jack noticed over the milk. When? Asked Bunny. Jack dropped the cup. Where? Asked Bunny. Jack spilled the marshmallows. Amazing, the bunny. Jack dropped the cocoa powder. Oh, he's dropping everything. And he said, I will be quiet, but he's not quiet. Right, said Bunny. She hugged up the telephone. Jack, what are you doing? Asked Bunny. Dropping, knocking, spelling, and lumping, said Jack. Plus being nice. Well, said Bunny. It's time to go to your work. We have a case. Really? Said Jack. He sat on a marshmallow smell. That's where Mr. Riley, who wants the music store on the counter, said Bunny. Someone keeps taking a trombone. Sorry, the sound is coming from upstairs. Taking a trombone off Jack and putting it back, said Bunny. Putting it back? Asked Jack. Right, said Bunny. We be better got over there. Jack stood up. Let's have our cocoa first, he said. There's your small marshmallow. There's mine. Bunny looked at him. You don't want to know, she said. Chapter 2, The Case. Mr. Riley meet Bunny and Jack at the door of the music store. Hello, Bunny. Hello, Jack, he said. How are you? Nice, said Jack. Bunny gave Jack a look. We are fine, Mr. Mr. Riley, she said, but how are you? Confess, said Mr. Riley. In the evening, when I close the store, a trombone is in the window, but the next morning it's gone. Then the next morning it's back. Then the next morning it's gone again. Then it's back. Oh, wow. You are making me dizzy, said Jack. Sorry, Mr. Riley. May we look at your window? Asked Bunny. Sure, said Mr. Riley. But the trombone isn't there. It's gone today, he said. But yesterday it was there, and in the morning it might may be back. I think I am gonna be sick, said Jack. Come on, Jack, said Bunny. Let's look for clues. Okay, said Jack, but let's not talk about last night and this morning and yesterday and today and the next morning, or I am throw up. Right, said Bunny. We will just look for clues. Jack is a very funny character. Oh, I forgot said Mr. Riley. The Trumbull did show up for a while yesterday morning, but then it got a run, said Jack, heading for a bathroom. Oh dear, said Bunny. I'll just have to start with him. Mr. Riley wanted back to work, and Bunny looked at the display window. She said, a piece of straw. She said again, muddy prints. You can see the muddy prints and the straw. She wrote down straw, muddy puddle. Bunny was still looking. When Jack came back, feeling better? Asked Bunny. Blah, said Jack. What is the sound? From the chair. It is. Sorry. Blah, said Jack. That was just chair sound. Said Jack. Did you solve it? Not yet, said Bunny. She showed Jack her gloves, straw and mud, said Jack. Sounds like a farm, or a burn, or a hybrid, said Bunny. Where have I seen that word? Asked Jack. Oh, Mr. Riley's door, said Bunny. Come on. Sure enough, on Mr. Riley's door, there was a sign of a hard ride. Take a hard ride with Gus. In his back, brass boys, red jack, brass, she said. Where are you going to have a highway ride? Hard ride. Take a hard ride. Just when I starting you to really like standing still, said Jack. Don't worry, said Bunny. You won't get dizzy again. Just don't invite Mr. Riley's to come with us, said Jack. I promise, said Bunny with a smile. Chapter 3. The Clipper. Jack picked Bunny up that night. He was wearing a cowboy hat. How they, he said. You look a bandit, said Bunny. All raccoons like bandit, said Jack. Yes, but hat makes you look like a professor. Oh no, bandit, said Bunny. Goodbye, said Jack. Do you like my boots? Asked Bunny. You look like a rabbit, said Jack. I am a rabbit, said Bunny. Yes, but boots make you look like a professional rabbit, said Jack. Oh, for heaven's sake, said Bunny. Let's go. Jack and Bunny took a taxi to the Harry Ride. I will be where you're the only person who ever took a taxi to a hardware, said Jack. Maybe, said Bunny. One day will they go to the farm. There were 13 taxi line in Gus Knot, said Jack. Come in, let's go look for Gus Big Brass Boy, said Bunny. Jack and Bunny strolled around the farm. People were singing and dancing everywhere. There were a lot of store. There was a lot of mud, and up on the hay wagon there was a trombone. Look, said Bunny. There's many taxis here. A young possum wearing a long scarf was playing the trombone. He was very good. When he finished, everyone clapped it. That's our girl, said Jack. How do you know? Asked Bunny. Look, said Jack, pointing. Against the barn was the trombone's case. It said, "Realist music." Bingo, said Bunny. What do we do now? Said Jack asked. We will follow him after we arrive, said Bunny. I will bet that takes the trombone back to the store. Right, said Jack. Oh, beans. Cowboys love beans. Want some? Sure, said Bunny. We may, as we will have fun while we are here. Yeah, said Jack. After eating beans, riding on hay and saying yaha a lot, Bunny and Jack went back to work. There Taxi followed the custom taxi all the way to Mr. Wheeler's store. Oh, it is chapter 4. I thought the taxi number is 4. When the possum stepped it at with trombone, they nabbed at him. Oh, it was a serene sight. The pushed it cried and cried. He told them how the hay wagon had rolled it over his own trombone. How he needed to place music to support his mother. How he had to sneak into Mr. Riley's store and borrow a trombone. Jack nearly cried too. Jack was sensitive. But Bunny was practical. Well, she said to Possum, whose name was Fridley, how about giving trombone lesson at Mr. Riley's store to pay for this one? Then it will be yours to keep. Really? Asked Fridley. Sure, said Bunny. Mr. Riley's a nice man, but he might make you dizzy, said Jack. Fridley promised he would talk to Mr. Riley the next day. Jack and Bunny said goodbye and wanted back to their high race. Another close loved. The bunny wants some cocoa. Can't, said Jack. I knocked over the milk, spilled the marshmallows, and dumped it into cocoa powder. Hum, said Bunny, but I sure was a nice, wasn't I? Said Jack. Very, said Bunny. Yaha, said Jack. Finished. Today I read the story. It was fun. Then bye.